Hey everyone, we are back. Hello, so the food was amazing, absolutely amazing. If there's another reason to come here and visit, it's the food. Absolutely incredible. Now we're gonna take you on a tour of the museum and give you a behind the scenes look of all the exhibits. A lot of it is still under construction. They will be opening next Saturday is their grand opening. So bear in mind there is still construction going on and there's a lot of media because today is the media preview day. So we're going to take you down into the exhibit. Hopefully we don't lose reception because it is below ground. There's 5 stories and it starts going back in time. So we're going to take you there now until you can come and visit next week. That was where they held the press conference this morning. We can take you inside so you can see.
Okay.
Again, today was the media opening, the media press conference, so they're allowing us in. Oh, no, they closed it. Oh, or not. The doors are just really heavy. Okay, so now we're gonna go back down through the exhibit. We went down there earlier. Since it's underground, we may lose service. Hopefully we don't. It starts going from now back in time and then it brings you to the present. So this is where you start the museum. So you can take an elevator down. As you can see, this is the elevator right here. And it starts from today and it brings you all the way back. Emerson, I'm not trying to shake the camera, but I'm walking. Okay, we're gonna take the stairs. Is it coming up? All right, we'll just take the stairs down.
We're still in progress on
glass. Yeah. No worries. We're just excited we get a sneak peek. Yeah. Elle, it's stunning. This place is huge. There's just so much to see. I'm not even sure you could get this done all in one day. It's amazing. Julian, it's not open to the public now. It opens next Saturday. Okay, so this is where you start. It takes you all the way back in time. So because it's still under construction, you're gonna see some paper over things and stuff like that. So bear in mind, this is the media preview. So not everything is done. They say everything will be done next Saturday when they have their first opening.
Just a second.
Absolutely. Wayne, they say there are 5 levels to this museum. So there should be 3 on the bottom that will go up. One level is still not available for us to look at, and then we should be able to take you to the top floor. Jocelyn, because we're media and today's the media preview, yes, we can get in that way. So that's kind of how we're in right now.
Perfect, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
As you can see, a lot of construction is still going on here. They still got a lot for me to open up. You can see some of their plans still everywhere. These numbers are very jarring. So here's the founding of America. Thomas Jefferson over here. The Declaration of Independence. As you can see, a lot of it really still is under construction, but they assured us today that they will be open and ready next Saturday.
Here's where we found the sun so far. Because in here it's like not good for TV.
Okay.
Good, but it's not good. Right.
So this is the Gola hat from Liberia. The video does not do it justice. Karen, you're absolutely gonna literally love it. It's absolutely stunning here. They did a really nice job. Yeah.
perpetuated itself through rape, and the fact that enslaved man is good is how to reproduce their own product. We made sure that we talked about.
So this is definitely hard to see right here. These are shackles. It says, enslaved mothers gave birth to enslaved children. However, the men, women, and children who endured slavery passed on much more. With each generation, they left powerful lessons about what mattered most. What people share and how they share deeply impacts the future. Through their stories, songs, memories, and personal artifacts, they prove that the human voice lives on. They showed that the love of family, friends, and strangers heals. So it says, during slavery, it seemed like your children belonged to everybody but you. Caroline Hunter recalled.
Okay, so is that your cell phone?
Yeah. My cell phone.
I'll
give
it to you. You all have to walk close with my feet hurt. And I would have liked to take the elevator.
Frederick
yeah,
Douglass.
Yeah, my feet are killing me in this shoes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. So I'm sorry.
No, fine. So let me send you a text then.
Okay.
Touch to begin, you can share your story. Very powerful.
Here's a photo of the Emancipation Day Parade in 1805. There's a little video area where you can sit and watch a video.
So this ramp goes
down to Clara Brown Pioneer.
With the outbreak of World War I in Europe, northern factories and steel mills were hired. At first, a trickle of families came north to New York, Pittsburgh, St. Louis, Philadelphia.
Whites only door, San Antonio, Texas. This door was used at a restaurant to keep Africans, African Americans, and Mexicans from using entrance to the business.
Well, see, ramp is.
No roof ramp.
Greensboro, North Carolina, set in February 1960.
If I can't sit up, you can't.
A guard tower. The Southern Railway Company.
Puts the Smithsonian in a different place than it's ever been.
So here's the rail car. It's kind of hard to see inside. It's by no means comfortable looking. Go up to the very next level.
Yes, ma'am.
Terry, this place is absolutely beautiful and the food is amazing. You're gonna really enjoy yourself here. It's a really great museum. Vince, yes, you can bring your camera and take photos. Kendra, you're absolutely welcome. We're entering into my personal favorite exhibit. There's the internet over there right now. Honor the King and Racism. Black Power. He's not porn. The Black Panther Party. The Foundations of Black Power.
They're in very diverse.
This jacket is too cool. Broad embrace of Black culture and identity. It called for an appreciation of the Black past as a worthy legacy and inspired cultural pride in contemporary Black achievements. It also focused on emotional and psychological well-being. The movement affirmed natural hairstyles like the Afro, a variety of skin colors, hair textures, and physical characteristics found in the African American community. Love that. Jobs, not bombs. Jobs, not bombs. There's a familiar face.
But for many African Americans, life in the city remained a struggle. City landscapes remain scarred by the urban rebellions of the 1960s.
Inner-city residents still faced
poverty, poor housing, dilapidated schools, and police brutality. Corporations were closing, and factories were heading overseas, taking jobs and unprotected.
Vince, if you get the opportunity to come and visit, you will be emotionally moved. I guarantee it. So we have the Oprah Winfrey area with her dress. Public Enemy. It says, by 1987, hip-hop was more than a decade old. The music encompassed social commentary, party anthems, and pro-Black messages. The group Public Enemy emerged with a politically conscious sound. Sounds like Fight the Power, Fear of a Black Planet, and 911 is a Joke conveyed the group's militant philosophy. Later rapper Chuck D called rap the CNN of young Black America in the 1980s, but by 1997 he noted rap is the CNN for young people all over the world. Michael
Jordan. Now, he donated, I believe it was $5 million to this museum to make sure it was as stunning as it is. President Barack Obama.
I'm going to say I was raised a Quaker, and I can remember going to the civil rights demonstration.
So this is Michelle Obama's dress. She's been widely admired for her sense of style. The First Lady concentrates her energy on parenting, promoting children's health and nutrition, and advocating for interests of military families. This dress was designed by Tracy Reese and worn by the First Lady in connection with the 50th anniversary of the March on Washington.
So, so you think I should introduce? Maybe I should introduce.
Yeah, you should say why you're in
it. You can actually leave that room. You can actually leave your room.
After my history, I was describing even when barriers present themselves, you always know how to go over
them. My name is Jace Moon.
The outside world told black kids they weren't worth anything, but our parents said it wasn't so, and our churches and our school teachers said it wasn't so, so they believed in us, and we therefore believed in ourselves. That's powerful. History, despite its wrenching pain, cannot be unlived, but if faced with courage, need not be lived again. Maya Angelou. Our lives matter. Change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the change that we seek. Barack Obama.
Well, we're doing this next Facebook Live.
And the, and the roof.
So that guy would just pass as one of the architects. I too am American. Langston Hughes. Facebook Live. If we can go live from upstairs, we will. If not, it was great taking you on this tour. We hope you enjoyed it.